Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
On the inside, Oklahoma Memorial Stadium is one of the most modern stadiums in the country, but it still has that old Plains charm. Football from Norman is on the way. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. Lawson fields it at the 7. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 48.
You gotta love opening the game with a solid kick return like this.
So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
Some daylight.
Good open field tackle.
That's a deep that brings in second and one.
Caught open field.
The linebacker here bites on the play fake. Once that happens, there's plenty of room for a nice completion.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 17. Sims on a counter. The 10. Touchdown, Oklahoma! He hits the PAT. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked 9th. After the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the pollsters move them down? David took the little rock. He slung it with all his might, and it hit Goliath right on the noggin, and down goes the Giant. The Broncos roll by 19.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Oklahoma lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Kirk, today we get to watch one of the great wide receivers in college football. Barber's footwork, his great hands, his speed, he is a dangerous offensive weapon.
No doubt, Brad. He's really one of the most exciting players to watch in college football. He catches everything that's thrown his way and is a legitimate deep threat downfield to make big plays for this offense. He's going to face some double, sometimes even triple team coverage. And I think today, this defense, they might do a decent job of slowing him down, but eventually, he's too dangerous. He's going to make some big plays.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game. Playmaker and tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. Set. Hale with a nice play fake. Throws it. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time, the quarterback threw it to a spot, and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
And, Herbie, we got a guy down after that play. First down. First and goal here inside the five-yard line. Two.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
Brought down right around the two-yard line. The offense is down by seven, so this is a very, very big third and goal. We're at the one. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Got his receiver, touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They'd love going to him down here.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Let's take a look at some action in the ACC. The Volunteers strike first with a rushing touchdown. And for Jenkins, he's got a rushing touchdown in this one. The Volunteers have the lead, 7-0.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Hall has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Taken from the 10. He's out to the 30. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. The Red Wolves running back left the game earlier with that injury. What we're hearing now, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to return to action today. And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
It to the 44.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Hands off of the middle and stuffed.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up second and 12.
From the 46-yard line, second down. Quick throw, picked off. And they'll return this one all the way.
Ashley with the interception.
Really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
From the 24-yard line, first down. Plenty of time in the pocket. And he's level at the 12-yard line.
Hard gain of 12 yards. First down.
Watch the slant.
And they make the stop at the 18.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
from the 18-yard line. Second down. Makes it out to about the 10.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up third and eight.
It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. This isn't much more than an extra point. Arkansas State is looking to go up by three. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
He fights forward to about the 30.
That makes it second and 10.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 10-7, Arkansas State. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Complete. He's got room. He gets hit out of bounds. Around the 36-yard line.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That makes it 3.
Mike 55. Eat. Check 50.
Squeeze.
Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Didn't get all of that one. And he can't hang on to the ball.
That's a tough break. Whether you lose the ball or not, it can mess with your head when that happens.
That return man is lucky that his team got the ball back, or he would have heard an earful from the coach. Actually, he probably will anyway. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Arkansas State has a 3-point lead. He's taken down around the 46-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle at the 32. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 10. Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. complete. Brought down. Nothing doing. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team. And he's taken down at the six.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
Arkansas State is up a field goal. Kicks away, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
He's tackled at the 47.
Miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37.
Hey, check right, check right.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. Punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Arkansas State's coaching staff this week, when we were at practice, Kirk, you could just see they were aiming for this guy to be the star of the game. And it's nice when you prep that way and things work out the way they have in the first two quarters.
Yeah, they put together a great plan, a plan that started on Sunday. They put a lot of work into this. You and I had a chance to sit down with the offensive coordinator and even the head coach. They were confident in what they'd be able to do against this defense. And just what they drew up and showed us is exactly the way it's played out so far in this game.
From their own 36-yard line, first down, Arkansas State up six. They'll bring him down at the 35.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
From their own 37-yard line, it's third down. I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds at the 44. A 7-yard play.
It's a well-designed play to the halfback, and it worked at least to get them a medium gain on the play.
Weatherford to punt. It's a short kick. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick throw. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Oklahoma is going to take their first time out of the half. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. He's got it out to his tight end. And down he goes around the 42-yard line. The Sooners use their second timeout.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
And they push him out right around the 40. First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. That's a great tackle at the 28. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Wow, Brad, you talk about having a strong arm. Next time, though, he might want to work on the accuracy.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Throw's complete, and he stopped immediately. Shot, the defender tips it away. They came close to giving up the score there.
Yeah, but credit the defender. He did an excellent job of reading the play and showing instinct to get a hand there to break the pass up. Nice job.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
It's good on Rocky Top as we check in Knoxville. Let's take a look at this one again.
The Hokies
have a lethal pass-catch combination for a touchdown. Tennessee leads it 14-7.
Well, you can never look ahead a week, but that would be a pretty big upset if that score holds. Oklahoma lines up for the kickoff. From the 7, he's to the 20, tries to get around the corner, and down he goes at the 28-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Arkansas State holds a field goal lead. Going long. Almost intercepted.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment and in position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Makes it out to about the 49. The Red Wolves are going to call their second timeout. From their own 49-yard line. First down. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He sails it long. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. He's had a good game, snaring passes for 100 yards.
You know, if you were to ask this defense, who wants to cover this guy? I bet you nobody's going to raise their hand because this receiver is embarrassing them.
He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. A great first half comes to a close. 16-10, Arkansas State.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being. Each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And It's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm going to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Arkansas State with a 6-point lead. Tackles him hard at the 33-yard line.
Gonzalez brings him down at the 33-yard line. That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. That makes it first and ten.
Caught with room to work. Brought down around the 45-yard line.
9 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He is drilled at the 49.
That's good for being 4 yards. First down.
Knocked out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line, second down. The Red Wolves saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. They bring him down in the backfield, and he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
Arkansas State is up by six. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
And that was such a good job of reading the coverage and knowing where his receivers were. Any coach in the country would be thrilled to see that kind of composure, especially on third down.
And he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
Second and one.
We're at play number nine of this current drive. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
Called a gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
This is the 11th play of this drive.
Here we go, here we
And he makes it out to about the 14-yard line. From the 14-yard line, second down. Gets to about the 14-yard line. Play 13 of the current drive. Arkansas State, up six. Here they come. Quick strike, and he drops it. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks up, and he got it. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Atlantic Coast Conference action in the spotlight. We've been watching this thing all day long. The Volunteers keep pounding away on the ground, and they find pay dirt. And for Jenkins, he's crossed the goal line twice on the ground. The Volunteers have the lead, 27-21. Elsewhere, the Fighting Irish take the field ranked eighth in the nation and hoping to prove they're worthy of so much more. Back and forth these two teams go, neither one giving an inch. We could be headed to a photo finish. The Fighting Irish have the edge, 21-20.
Well, if that score holds up, that would be water cooler talk on Monday morning. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll get him for a loss.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
So it's second and 13. Ball on their own 26. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. Scrambling. And he's taken down at the 45.
That'll make it second and four.
Tackle at about the 45. Taken down at the 41.
Gain of four on the way. That makes it second and six.
I hope you brought your left because I'm about to take you to school. 278.
Fires quick. He catches another. Tackle made at the 29. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 19-10, Red Wolves. Fourth quarter.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball right here.
Mike, 55. Right there in the middle. 55.
He's tackled at the 30-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 30-yard line. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. They'll bring him down at the 4-yard line. Touchdown, OU. He makes the PAT. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Seminoles come in today's game ranked number 6, and we've been keeping an eye on this one all day. And for FSU, they've taken the lead. Florida State has the edge, 23-21.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. Wright looks ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. Tackle at the 15-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Arkansas State holds just a 2-point lead. And he's tackled right away.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 29-yard line, it's first down. Down he goes at the 30.
That brings up second and 9.
Check right.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and they push him out at the 40-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he shoved out of bounds at the 50-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That brings up second and 1.
Quick throw, almost intercepted. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. Weatherford is set back, ready to punt. He'll probably try to pooch this one into the corner. It's away, short punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He goes out of bounds around the 23-yard line. They go to him on a quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds at the 36. From their own 36-yard line, first down. He's on the run. And they make the stop at the 39. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. Fourth quarter.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down. Under pressure, and he hits him hard at the 31-yard line. Left in the game. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's knocked down of bounds at the 23-yard line.
That's good for 87 yards.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Kicker's on the field, and you can bet that he hasn't kicked many more important kicks than this one in his career. This is for the lead. The kick is up, and he got it. Oklahoma ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, we're getting late in the fourth quarter, Kirk. You've got to make the most of every possession you have. Barber's legend now has got a chance to grow if they can get him the football.
I'd be throwing the football his way early and often during this drive. You never know what can happen once the football gets in his hands.
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
First down.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. Under heavy pressure. And he's immediately tackled.
Easy. Tiger! Ready? Red 88! Red 88!
Tackle just sealed the deal. Barber's big performance today. It's going to be tough for him to celebrate, though, because they end up with a loss.
Well, it's a tough day for his team. You know, he had a great individual performance, but you know, you think about the team first, obviously, if you're this star player, and he cannot. not be happy with, even though he had a great game, this team ends up losing the football game.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.